Mumia Abdul-Jamal, a black child born in the projects of North Philadelphia, and a black child who did not graduate from high school, but saw the need to go back in his revolutionary movement, his thirst to know more, to learn more. But it was the street education that gave him that zest, that zeal to continue to fight as Martin Luther King. And when they said that Mumia will never come off a death row, you had presidents in this country that stood up. I'm talking about the power of the people. The power of the people. The power of us, what we possess. And Mumia is no longer on death row. When they tried to kill him on death row, we rose up. And right here, people came of all colors, of all, backgrounds, came to Philadelphia to stand in the street and said, oh, no, you won't. We're lending our voices. So he came off of death row. Then they tried to kill him, through medical neglect. They gave him hepatitis C. What would happen with that, it exposed everything that was happening inside the prison. Watching the time, how much time I got? The hepatitis C. When my man got hepatitis C, we still following and we dealing with Martin, we still dealing with Move, because when you have the truth and you find out the problems, like Martin, when he started, and it was like the marches in the street where people were beat up. It was a strategy. It was an awesome strategy of non-violence to bring attention to the violence of this government and how violent it can be upon people that are innocent. Because what happened on them bridges when Dr. Martin Luther King was beat up, it was nothing out of the norm. It was the norm. This is what was happening in our community to small group of people who stood up against the injustice, whatever it was that was happening to them. Brother King stood up. Brother King got beat up, thrown in jail. Mumia Abdul-Jamal stood up and got shot, thrown in jail. They tried to kill him. My family, they dropped a bomb killing 11 black men, women, and children because they couldn't stop it. RZA was known as one of the most horrible, Hitler spitting son of a guns that ever walked the face of the earth. He killed black people with impunity and just kept on having his cops kill black people. And Uncle Move took a position that no longer, after you had murdered, locked up, threw our people in jail, Martin Luther King, we haven't left him. We haven't left him. We're talking about an example of righteousness, because in order to get what we want, we have got to fight. And I'm saying, I ain't talking about picking up no gun. I'm saying, it's something that goes on every level. And this stuff, that ain't what we talking about. We talking about people who came together to pull Mumia off of death row. We talking about people who came together to make sure that the hepatitis C that Mumia was suffering from, and what we found out in dealing with hepatitis C with Mumia, that there was in the state of Pennsylvania, it was, oh damn, the thousands that was in there. 46,000 people in the state of Pennsylvania who had hepatitis C. Then we found out as we continued to move, because you can't stay in one place in order to win a fight. When you get into it, 47,000 in the prisons. As we go into it, we want to find out more about this hepatitis C, because we didn't know. So we went places where we had never been before, and we teamed up with people that we hadn't worked with before. We went to the AIDS clinics with the brothers and sisters there who had information about hepatitis C that the politicians didn't have. Then we had to make sure that they had it. They was the ones who told us, and we always let it know, be known to the people who said, oh my God, when they get out, they're coming out with this hepatitis C and we're all going to be infected. What we found out, that there was 46,000 in the city, not the state, but the city of Philadelphia, of men, women, and children of all colors, of all Republicans, Democrats, liberals, and all who had this hepatitis C disease. What we found out that in order to get the cure, not the maybe cure, but to get the cure, it costs $1,000 a pill. People said that you will never be able to get this for Mumia unless you get it for everybody else. Well, I'm here to tell you, when we fight for Mumia, when we raise Martin's name, when we raise the name of Mu, we are talking about the everybody else. And do that when you join together. Because what I'm saying, ain't no power like the power of the people. When the power of the people don't stop, and we were able to get that hepatitis C cure for everybody in the state.